We'll be looking to take it to the skies here.
Looking to fly champion outside the ring. Down goes Daniel Bryan.
To be able to say you're the first African champion, I mean, how does that feel?
I mean, when you say, I get like chills, you know? It's amazing to be the first, you know? I can barely even put it into words. I'm awe-stricken.
Yeah.
And it's an amazing honor, obviously, because there will never be another first.
Man who is so proud of his family, so proud of his background.
What has it been like to, you know, work at this company for 11 years and then finally, you know, reach the top of it?
Man, the feeling is indescribable. I a lot of times I feel like it's a dream, you know, when people are like, oh yeah, you're the WWE champion. Like, I have to kind of like step back. It's still very, very weird to hear. Mm-hmm. Because like you said, it's been 11 long years. I've seen a lot of people come and go. I've seen the industry change. I've seen a lot of different movements kind of take place. I've seen people start from behind me and pass me and become WWE champion, all the while I just keep working, you know? And it's very easy to get discouraged, and it's very easy to want to quit or to stop. But for me, I've had this internal drive to and this belief that I could be at the top. And I'm glad that I stuck with it. It might have taken 11 years, but I can say that I'm the WWE champion. Like, I'm holding this same title that, you know, Shawn Michaels held and The Rock held and, you know, and The Undertaker held and Bret Hart. Like, this is what it's all about, just being able to persevere.
11 long years!
And my Ghanaian name is Kojo.
Yeah.
And so I was born on Monday, yours is Friday, yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
So when I saw you join the WWE and I saw Kofi Kingston, I was like, oh my God, there's a Ghanaian in the WWE. And then they started calling you Jamaican. What was that all about?
When I was first getting involved with wrestling in general, when I was trying to break into the business, the whole thing was that you needed to have a character. And there was a guy who was wrestling for a different wrestling promotion named Prince Nana.
Yeah.
So he was already doing like a Ghanaian thing. So I didn't want to come across as like, oh, he's Ghanaian, now it had already been done before. Yeah. What hadn't been done was a Jamaican character. And I had, been listening to the Damian Marley CD, Welcome to Jamrock. Just one day we had a promo class and I was just like, well, what am I gonna do? Let me try Kofi Kingston. Yo, Kingston, Jamaica. And I cut a promo on Ric Flair about him stealing my Jamaican beef patty. So everyone was just like, they lost their minds because they had never seen anything like that before. And then we were off to the races. Mm. Kofi Kingston was born.
You've kind of got to the top without, you know, playing to the typical stereotype of what a black man should be. You are yourself and you are completely at ease with who you are, it seems.
Oh yeah.
When did you, you know, become comfortable with being able to be yourself?
It was a gradual thing. Playing the Jamaican character was something that was definitely entertaining, but I know my accent was terrible, and it's hard enough to remember like what you have to say, let alone how to say it. Yeah. So I think it kind of started when I was able to like drop that accent and just be, you know, and just be myself and turn that volume up. And I think, so for myself, Big E and Xavier, my partners, were the New Day, you know, and one of the most important things for us is to be ourselves.
Their opponents making their way to the ring, the New Day!
You know, we come out, we wear pancake tracksuits, you know, we wear unicorn horns, we throw out pancakes, we have a cereal called Bootios, we like ice cream, you know, we go out there, we dance, we twerk, we're us. And a lot of people are like, whoa, well, you're embarrassing yourself. Nah, it's like, what we want people to do in the world is to be comfortable in their own skin.
Just tell me about how important the continent is to you and being a Ghanaian is.
I think it's always important to know where we came from. And, you know, I remember asking my mom and dad quite a bit about just the history of Ghana and where, you know, where I came from and, you know, my name and, you know, even as a kid, I was mad that my parents named me Kofi because I would go to school and get made fun of for my name. Kofi, coffee, oh, and I'd be, you know, so angry about that. But now, you look up Kofi, you type it in the Google search, and I'm the first name that comes up. You know, me and Kofi Annan. For a while, we were, you know, neck and neck right there. So I'm in pretty good company, and I just think it's an awesome thing to be unique, you know, and it just means the world to me. And you know, being Ghanaian is, I just have the most, just the utmost sense of pride to be a Ghanaian.